They say greats are born every decade, but legends just once every century. One such selfless and self-made man who reshaped India and made it insignificant was Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Today we will walk on his path, which transformed a paper boy into the missile man of India. Let's imbibe some pearls of wisdom from him. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was born in a small town, underprivileged family. Providing everyday necessities was a task for his father, Jainulabdin. Dr. Kalam couldn't just watch his father bear all the burden. He had to do something to unload the pressure. So, at the tender age, when everyone should be enjoying life, he started selling newspapers to support his family. He soon realized education was the key to fulfilling his dreams. And with enough courage, he asked his parents to let him go to school. His father, who had always encouraged him to learn, didn't think for a second before saying yes. Soon enough, he left Rameshwaram and a new chapter in his journey began. Being a small-town boy, living in a city without family was scary. But he made his parents proud when he graduated with a BSc degree in 1954. He started developing an interest in the aeronautical field. His dreams led him to Madras to study aerospace engineering at MIT. Others were concerned about the cutoffs. He passed with flying colors, but it was the college fee that worried him the most. His parents, who had never let him down, couldn't help him. The gates of MIT seemed to be closing for Kalam. Just when every hope had died, his elder sister, who knew his capabilities, sold her jewelry and paid his fees. This gesture deeply moved him. He thanked her and promised to put every ounce of effort into achieving the goals. In 1962, Incospar decided to develop modern rockets in India, and thus came the opportunity to travel to NASA. A small boy from small town who wanted to rise from poverty was representing India in America. While working there, he noticed the strengths and flaws in many leaders and thus decided to be the leader he wanted to be. He once said, "Let me define a leader. He must have a vision and passion and not be afraid of any problem. Instead, he should know how to defeat it. And most importantly, he must work with integrity." Professor Sarabhai wanted to develop an Indian satellite launch vehicle. This created several challenges. Many claimed it would never succeed. Dr. Kalam, however, backed the professor's proposal, since he knew the key to a nation's development lies in its scientific and technological capabilities. He learned a lot from the professor and later stated, "Great teachers emanate out of knowledge, passion, and compassion." Dr. Kalam also visited Professor Sarabhai and updated him on the progress. He was on one such visit to meet him, but as soon as he landed at the airport, he heard about the sad demise of Professor Sarabhai. He was stunned. A person who stood like a concrete wall behind him was no more. And the only way to tribute him was by continuing the work which he had begun. Dr. Kalam was diverting his mind from the loss by investing all his time in his work. But fate had something else in mind. One day, he received a call and was told about the death of a really good friend. This was just the beginning of the storm. Not long after that, he witnessed his father's death. His mother couldn't handle this trauma well. Everyone tried their best to make things better for her, but nothing worked. And soon enough, she also followed his father's path. One blow after the other, fate had taken everything from him. His parents didn't possess any financial assets. nor were they academically inclined, but they taught him invaluable life lessons. He had no choice but to immediately get back to work. SLV was finally ready. After the launch, SLV cleared the first few phases quite quickly. But due to some unexpected disturbances, SLV crashed in the fourth phase, and the dreamlike SLV was shattered into pieces. They say leaders stand behind in victory and front during failure. That's precisely what he did. He took the entire responsibility for the crash on his head. But he knew if he gave up now, all the years of hard work and sacrifice would go in vain. Though the criticism kept growing, he still decided to launch another SLV. He believed in never stop fighting until you arrive at your destined place, which made this launch successful. After the success of SLV, he was felicitated with the Padma Bhushan. He was honored, but he knew this accomplishment wasn't his alone. Dr. Kalam dedicated his success to those who supported him but weren't there with him. His father, his mother, and his mentor, Professor Sarabhai. This incident taught him a lot. He later stated, "We should not give up, and we should not allow the problem to defeat us. The 1990s changed everything. If India wanted to compete with other powerful countries, it needed nuclear power, and thus a program began." During this period, Dr. Kalam played an intensive political and technological role. For his achievement, he was awarded Padma Vibhushan and the title of the Missile Man of India. In 2002, he was elected as the President of India. He was lovingly called the People's President. In 2015, Dr. Kalam was giving a speech to the youth in Shillong. And during his speech, he suffered from cardiac arrest. About 35,000 people attended his funeral and prayed for such a great soul. A kid from a small town who had set out to change his own financial situation had changed the country's dynamics.